everyone, this is Deborah Clutter. I have a few minutes. I've actually been laying floors and painting walls, and I'm actually pretty tired. So I have a few minutes and I need to catch up on some projects. So I have this, it's a star quilt, and I'll show you a picture of what it looks like, a little short video. And this I made as something I was going to put up on YouTube, and I'll show you guys how to make it. So I gotta put the borders on this. I have to finish this quilt, which is from one of my videos with the little spool blocks. And then I have this one that I need to finish. My Judy Niemeyer quilt I need to finish. And I was hoping I would get that done before September. That's when the quilt show is, and close to me. And I'm not gonna be able to do it. So I just wanted to chat a little bit while I'm sewing. So anyway, I cannot talk and do something at the same time. That's why a lot of times in my videos, if I'm like on the computer and I'm trying to tell you what's happening, I have a hard time thinking and doing. I just want to do or think and not combine those two things. So it's difficult for me, and I have no idea why. So talking is hard for me as it is. So add talking and doing something is like walking and chewing gum, I guess. It makes it really hard. I have about 5 quilts I need to quilt, and that's why I'm doing a lot of the long arm Tuesdays. I need to get through some of those quilts. I hope you guys really like those. I worked days on those videos, and I had this idea in my head, and this is what I wanted to do. It took me 2 days to edit the first video. And then a day and a half to edit the second video. And this next one, I am thinking about custom quilting that big dream panel, which is 108 inches. And some of the petals won't even fit in the quiltable space of my long arm. So what am I gonna do with that? I don't even know. So do I have to roll it? Do I like quilt a feather halfway and then roll a quilt? I'm not even sure yet. But I know I'm out of practice for freehand or free motion quilting, so it might be a good time to give it a try and you know, get back at it. I have so many different interests, and so I'll go from one thing to another, and so I'll maybe one day I'll be 3D printing a lot of stuff. Oh, I have to show you some of my stuff that I have done lately. All right, here's some stuff I 3D printed lately, and this one is a ruler holder, and I actually made a bigger one also, but this one is just for 4 rulers, and because that's really all I needed, something small. And I had bought these cutters over at the quilt show in Paducah, and I didn't think I'd like this type of cutter. Oh my gosh, it really feels good to be able to do it that way. So I made this little box to put my cutters in, so I don't actually close it. I can stick it in this box and won't cut myself. And I have the smaller one, which has the guide on it for the rulers that they sell. And I've been working on a zipper jig. And so I have this one, and a friend of mine was wanting one that she could clamp down. I was gonna make this one so you could take this part off and then put it on a clamp for the side of your table. But I haven't got that far. This is as far as I've gotten. Another thing I wanted to show you, I organized all my zippers. So I stuck them on these little clips, and then I didn't realize I had this many zippers, and put them on this ring. And those are just 4 regular zippers, right? And then I have zipper by the yard. So I 3D printed these spools, and in the middle it has a place to put the zipper heads. You can hear them in there, and then the zippers just go on there. So I have these are the smaller ones, and then I have bigger ones for, you know, if you have a lot more zippers. Oh, and one more thing. I made this for my embroidery machine to put my threads down. And this one, I made it so that you could take it apart and, you know, put it away. Or if you only needed 4 or 6 or whatever, you can make it any size you want. And it just, they fit together like this. And I think it works out okay. So I might be doing that. I might be designing quilts on my computer. I might be doing a lot of that. I might be digitizing embroidery one day, or digitizing long arm patterns, which is what I did this morning. Or I might be quilting, or I might be sewing, or I might be making a bag, you know. So I'm just kind of all over the place. I get bored if I do the same thing. So when I get back to, you know, long arming, sewing even, or whatever, you have to get back into the swing of things, and it takes a little bit. So I hope you guys are looking forward to the next Long Arm Tuesday, and I'll tell you how long it takes to quilt that quilt and how much I would charge to free motion a quilt like the one we're gonna do. And I'm not gonna really do an intense free motion quilting on it. I think I'm just gonna do feathers, you know, and all the petals, just different kind of feathers. I'm not gonna try to get too crazy and do, I may put a fill in or two. I'll probably change my mind, so we'll just have to wait and see what it looks like. So I probably have to get started now in order to finish it. I still gotta, my grandkids are coming over this weekend, and so I won't be able to do anything. And then I gotta do some stuff for the guild, and then I got floors to lay. My husband didn't want to pay somebody to lay floors. So floor installer, him and I, over 60. Yeah, fun. So I'm at my other machine. I gotta bind a quilt. So I have several machines. I actually gave one away, so I have one less. I gave one of my baby locks away to my sister, because I love her. Anyway, I need to bind this quilt that I did not finish in my last video, because I was having one of those days. And I think everybody's had one of those days where you pick something up, it falls out of your hand, you go to do something and it doesn't work right. I was having one of those days. Everything was just, nothing was going according to plan. So usually when I'm having those type of days, I just need to stop. And that's what I did. I just kind of stopped. And went upstairs and lay down with my puppy. So I had this idea, and you know how you see those channels where, okay, I've been watching a lot of those cleaning channels where they go in and they clean people's houses for free, and then they just put a video up of it. Or they mow somebody's lawn and they put up a video. I thought about, well, I wonder if I could quilt for somebody and just put up a video. But how would you do that without it costing you money? Because if somebody sent me a quilt that needed to be quilted, or, you know, they just didn't have the funds to have it quilted, or they just didn't know how to quilt it, or maybe it was their mom's quilt and they wanted it quilted for themselves, there's still some cost involved with the shipping of the quilt back and forth. And, you know, depending on where you live, there's cost in the backing, there's cost in the batting, you know. All those things cost money. And I'm willing to put in my time for free, but, you know, I don't think I could long-term do, you know, the cost of everything. If I had, like, some sponsors for batting or backing or, you know, different things like that, maybe I could do that. Or if I had I don't know, memberships or something, maybe, and that might help alleviate some of the cost. I don't know. What do you guys think? I like making things for people, and I like giving stuff away. I don't really like selling it. I mean, I could sell a lot of my 3D printed stuff, and I wouldn't mind just printing them and asking for donations, but you want something I 3D printed, you can send me an email, and if you want to pay for the postage, I'll send it to you. If you want to give me a donation, that's fine, but I'm not going to put a price on it, and I'm not going to sell it.
Thanks for watching. I hope you watch my new Long Arm Tuesday video. I'll have it in the description. Thanks.